Hello, everybody. Welcome back to yet another week of Island Rhythmic Gymnastics online recreational program. I hope everyone's doing really well this week and you've been having a really good time doing these online gymnastics classes. It's good to see that lots of you are watching the videos. That makes me really happy and I hope you're enjoying them. For today's class, we have a few focuses. As per usual, we have a stretching focus, and that today is going to be on our toes. For that, you are going to need one piece of equipment. Hopefully everyone has one. Just a towel, kind of any sort. I've got kind of a big dish towel here, which probably should use a wash. You could use a hand towel from the bathroom, a dish towel from your kitchen. Ask your mom or dad if they have something you could use of that sort. After stretching, we're gonna do a little bit of ballet. So you will need either just a clear space on the wall that you're able to put your hand on and have enough room around your legs. Or you could use a chair as well. I don't have a chair that's the appropriate height, but something that's about hip height. So when you put your hand out, your arm is resting about so. That could be a countertop, it could be a stool for you maybe. The back of a chair often works really well, so you'll need one of those. I'm gonna do it without any equipment so you guys can watch my legs and I don't have anything in my way, but it's helpful to have something to balance on, so you'll need that. The other thing you'll need is we're gonna do a little bit of, I guess it's not rhythmic gymnastics apparatus, but working towards rolls with a ball. If you have a ball, that's absolutely great. I think Angela made sock balls with you guys, so feel free to use those. If you don't have that, what I've been using is a rolling pin. Seems to work really well for rolling down the arms, things like that. So if you have a rolling pin, ask your mom and dad for one of these. If you don't, some of the other things you might be able to use is a paper towel roll. So this can be rolled down the arms as well. You could use like an old aluminum foil roll or even just the inside of the roll. Ask your parents for something like this to practice your rolls. Just be mindful though, if you're in an apartment or condo where there's people below you, if you're dropping a rolling pin on the ground, it might be a little bit loud or could actually break the rolling pin. So just be careful. If you prefer to use a paper towel roll, that might be a little bit better. The other thing you'll need just for our warm-up, I'm going to use a cushion to jump over, but you could use, say, like your favorite stuffed animal. You could use a pillow cushion that you find, pretty much anything that you can jump over. So we're gonna be working on that. As per usual, please be careful. Watch your surroundings. Make sure there's nothing that you're gonna trip on or anything that you might knock over. Just clear out a nice big space so you don't have to worry about it. Make sure you grab a little bit of water as well if you need to, so you can have a break, have a sip of water, and that's all. So let's get started with our warm-up a little bit here. We are going to put, whatever you guys come up with, put our device just kind of in the middle of the ground here. So I'll put my camera down, back up a little bit here. So what I want you to do is, I want you to run around your pillow or your stuffy or whatever it is. I want you to run around three times. So we're gonna go this way first. So we're gonna go running, running, running. Good, that's two and three. Stop. And we're gonna go the other way. We're gonna go three times. Running, running, running. Be careful not to trip and fall. And three. And we're gonna go back the other way again. Running, running, running. And freeze. And we're gonna go back again the other way. That's two. One more. And freeze. Good job. Now we're gonna do some big froggy ribbit jumps. So from here, I want you to do your biggest froggy ribbit all the way over your pillow. So we're going to go ribbit and over. Good job. And then we're going to come back around and we're going to do another ribbit jump. Ready? One, two, three. Big jump. Good job. We're going to do one more of those. Ready? One, two, three. Jump. Good job. If you feel comfortable, I want you to try a sideways jump. So start on one side of your pillow. And from here, we're going to jump over our pillow this way. Ready? One, two, three. Up and over. Good job. We're going to go to the other side now. Up and over. And up and over. And up and over. So careful not to fall. We're going to do that a few more times. Ready? So I want to see your biggest froggy ribbit jumps that you can do. We're going to go up and over, side to side. Ready? And ribbit. And up. And two. And three. Whoop, good job. All right, we can put this one away. Put it back wherever you found it. And we're gonna do a little bit more cardio. So I wanna see your highest knees. You can pump your arms, but we're gonna do knees up nice and high. Ready? One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20. Good job. We're gonna take a little break. And then when you're ready, we're gonna do another 20. Ready? Five, six, seven, eight, 20. High knees. One, two, three, four, five, six, 9, 10, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20. Good job. All right, hopefully your heart rate's up a little bit and your body's feeling warm. We're gonna start our stretching. So as per usual, we'll start with our neck from here. Just going from one side to the other. Keeping our shoulders down. Good job. And when you're ready, you can do your chin roll. So bringing the chin down towards the chest. Good job. And we'll do our shoulders, some nice big shoulder circles, trying to keep your elbows straight. So keep these ones, elbows, straight and forward circles. Good job. And we'll go up to the ears, whew, relax and down. And deep breath in and whew, relax. Up and down. And one more time. Up and down. Good job. We're going to do our big arm circles now. So just watch around you. Make sure there's nothing you're going to hit. We're going to go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. 10. Good. And we're going to stretch up. Good job. And we're going to go 10 forwards. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Good job. Clasp your hands behind your back. If you like, you can just stay here, making sure that you keep your tailbone tucked in and your belly button towards your spine. So you're not sticking your bum out like this. Just stay straight, lifting your arms up as high as you can. If you like, you can bend over and relax the arms towards the ground, getting a nice stretch in your arms. Hold that one for another 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Good job. Come out of that one. Give your arms the old shake, shake. Good job. We're going to do our shoulder stretch. So keeping the shoulder down, not up to the ear, push it down. And we're going to scoop under and stretch that shoulder. Good job. Holding the core. So that's this area, holding your belly nice and tight. Good job. We're going to go to the other side. So arm comes across the body. We scoop on under and we pull it across. Good job. right. Lovely. From here, we're going to start stretching our side body. So we'll come up and over, drawing those nice big rainbows up in the sky. Good job. And we're going to come to the other side. So from here, reaching up as high as you can, up and over, making a beautiful rainbow. Good. If you like, you can imagine you're painting all the colors of the rainbow. Good. All right. And you can name those colors now if you want to. All right. And from here, we're going to go all the way to the other side once more. Good job. All right, lovely. We're gonna do our hips a little bit. So hands on your hips. We're gonna go hips just side to side. Getting them warmed up a little bit. Good job. All right, and then we're gonna do our hip circles one way. So making sure you stretch nice and far forwards and backwards. Ooh. It's like a giant hula. We're gonna go the other way. Good job. All right, hopefully your hips are feeling warmed up a little bit, as well as your shoulders and your upper body. We're gonna start our first toe stretching from here, actually standing up. So I'll just kind of angle the camera down here so you can see what I'm doing. So standing nice and tall on one leg, I want you to come up and then push over your toe with the other leg. So some of you might only be able to get a little bit ways over. That's okay, as long as you feel a good stretch and not a painful stretch. So it should feel okay. And I want you to really push into that toe. Good. And making sure that we keep it straight. So instead of coming over the little baby toes like this, I want you to stay over the big one. So pushing into your toes, good job. Now we're gonna go the other side. So pushing over the foot into those, towards the knuckles of your toe. And again, not on the baby toes, we wanna stretch over the big toe. Good job. So we're just gonna hold this one. And then we're gonna go back to the other side again. So switching back to the first side. Good, you can kind of pulse in and out. If you feel like holding it in that position is too much of a stretch for you, you can come in and out, just pushing on the toes, getting them to curl over nicely. Good. So pushing. Keeping a nice strong balance on the legs, so not all of my weight is going into this leg. I'm staying strong on this one. All right, lovely. So that's kind of the first of our toe exercises. If you want to stretch each side, we're going to switch 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8. Lovely. And now we're going to stretch the other way. So see how this kind of looks like when I stand on tippy toes. But I want you to do one flat and one on tippy toes and push the ankle over. So you stretch the toes the opposite way. Good. So we'll just do a few of these. Nice. Really leaning into your toes. And we'll do the other side as well. Good, so now our ankles should feel nice and warm. I'm gonna bring the video down here so you can really see my feet. All right, so from here, what we're gonna do is we're gonna sit up on our feet like this. We're gonna put one leg in front and then we're gonna lean back and bring our knee off the ground so that you're pulling into the ankle a little bit. And just coming back and forth. Good. Wonderful. And we'll go to the other side. So I'll just bring the video up so you can see how my body is. So from here, oops, sorry, I need to do the other side. My one leg comes up, and I put my arms behind me a little bit, and then I just bring my knee up, just a touch, so that I'm really stretching the front of my ankle. Good job. If you want, you can hold it here for a bit more of an intense stretch. Whatever you feel is within your abilities. Good. All right. Lovely. Off to a good start. So now is the time that we're going to need our dish towel or our face towel or hand cloth, whatever you're able to find. I'll just grab mine here. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to lie it out nice and flat. And I'm going to fold it in half, so it's about like so. And I'm going to gather it into my hands and put it around my toe. So you can see that it's come around my toe here. And I'm going to use that to pull my foot down. So I'll just back up here so you guys can see. And I'll fold mine a little bit smaller. So I'm putting it around my toes here, and then I'm pulling it straight so that I can pull my foot down towards the ground, and I'm pulling on my toe. And notice how I'm not pulling in like so that I go pigeon-toed. I'm gonna keep it nice and straight. So I'm getting a good stretch. So underneath the towel, this is what my foot is gonna look like, and the towel is pushing my foot into the point position. So folding it up, and then you can use that towel. So I pull on the towel and bring my foot into that pointed position. So I want you to hold on one side. Good job. And then we're gonna switch on to the other side. So again, fold your towel. Maybe I might fold mine in half again. So I folded it in half once, and then I fold it in half again. You can ask your parents to help you with this one, get it set up. And then I just put it over my toes like so. And then as I straighten my knee out, I use that towel to pull my toe into the pointed position. So you can pull, 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 pull. Good job. And when you feel it's enough of a stretch, take a little break, flex your foot in the opposite direction. So bring your foot up, and you can even bend your toes in the opposite direction. So pull them back if they need a little break. And then if you like, you can go into it again. So you're really stretching that point of your toes. This is gonna help you have a nice, long, beautiful point. Good job. So pulling on that towel. So here I pull. Good job. All right, lovely. Hopefully that was all right for you guys. What we're gonna do next is you're gonna set your towel up just flat on the ground. And I'm gonna put it on the concrete. It's a little bit slippery, so I'm able to scrunch it up with my toes. So I'm gonna stand at the edge of my towel, and I'm gonna scrunch my toes and try and pull my dish towel all the way in. I have to scrunch quite a few times here. And if you can't get it all the way in, that's okay, as long as you get a good toe exercise. So it might be a little bit hard to see what I'm doing, but I'm scrunching my toes up like so, trying to pull my dish towel in. And once you get all the way through one side, you're gonna go and do the other side. So trying to pull it in with your toes. Oh my goodness, this side is really hard. Good. Oh. That is a good toe exercise, let me tell you. Good job. I think I've kind of reached the end of what I can get under my foot here. If you've got all your towel under, awesome. Good job. If you can't, like me, that's all right. Just do as much as you can. And then I want you to do one more time on each side. So I'll give you a second to do that. So really working on scrunching in those toes. Nice and strong, pulling on one side, And then pulling to the other. Good. So you might get a little bit of a toe cramp from this one. And if you do, just take a little rest. Give your foot a little massagey massage. Nice. All right. I think we're in business here. We're going to do our flex and point now. I'll just put the camera down so you can see my toes. So from here, we're going to do our flex and point. So I want you to straighten your knees as much as you can, sitting up through your core, and we're going to go flex and point. Flex, point, flex, point, flex, point, flex, point, flex, point, sitting up tall. Flex and point. And switching. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Good. And we do our ankle circles. So we're going to go 8 one way. So that's 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8. And now we go the other way for 8. 1, 2, 3, sitting tall, 4, 5, knees straight, 6, 7, and 8. Good job. Give your legs a little shaky rumble rumble. Good. And from here, we're going to focus just on the toe part. So from here, I like to hold my feet down, and then it's just my little toes that are going to come up. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8. Good. And from here, I'm going to flex my whole foot up, and then I'm just going to scrunch my toes. So similar to what we were doing on the ground. From here, we're just going to scrunch our toes and up. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8. And now what we're going to do is we're going to combine the foot and the toes. So I want you to start with a flex foot, and I want you to scrunch your toes and then point the whole foot. And then you're going to flex just the toes and then flex the whole foot. So we go point the toes, point the foot, flex the toes, flex the foot, point the toes, point the foot, flex the toes, flex the foot, point the toes. Point the foot, flex the toes, flex the foot, once more, point and point, flex the toes, and flex the foot. Good job. Hopefully your feet are feeling all right. If they need a little massage, you can do that, or maybe your calf muscles. Give them a nice little massage in here. That was lots of work, so good job. All right. We're going to get into the rest of our stretching now. So I'll just adjust the camera a little bit here. We'll put it up like so. And I'll just come back down onto the ground. I had a stool once upon a time, but maybe not. All right. So, sitting on the ground. Lovely. So from here, I'm going to bring one foot up. And reaching tall and coming forward. I want you girls to hold this one. I'm gonna go find another stool for me to put my camera on. So holding nice and strong. Hopefully this will work. All right. And I think we should be ready to switch to the other side. Good. That's not what I was feeling. That's all right. So let's switch on over to the other side. So bring that leg in, and we're gonna come up nice and tall, and we're gonna come forward with the body. Good job. Making sure to keep both shoulders facing the ground. So instead of turning up like so, we're gonna bring both shoulders, and instead of no hunchback turtles. I want to see flat back as best you can. If you can't reach your foot and you're only at your shin, that's okay, as long as you feel a good stretch kind of in your low back and your hip.
So just going as far as you're able to. Good job. All right, and from here we're going to try a new stretch. Some of you might have done this one before with me, but it's for our calf muscle. So that's this big muscle behind here. I want you to interlace your fingers, put them behind your foot, and we're going to pull that leg up straight. So notice how my leg is straight and not bent, and my back is nice and flat. My shoulders are relaxed, and my foot at the top is flexed. So you should feel a big stretch down the back here. If that's a little bit too much, just back off and bring it a little bit lower. So the higher you bring it up, the more of a stretch you're going to feel. If you need to bend your elbows, that's fine. Keeping a nice flat back. We're holding for 3, 2, 1, and relax. Good job. So interlace your fingers again. We're going to do the opposite leg. So pointing this toe now and flexing the one we're going to bring up, sitting nice and tall with our backs, sitting up and flexing that foot, keeping the knee straight. Good. Holding nice and strong. Trying not to lean back too much, so notice that I'm sitting up straight. Good. All right, and we'll relax that one. Good job. Give your legs a little shake out, and we're going to reach up tall to the sky and folding forward with flat back, so my belly button is the first thing that comes forward, and relaxing. If you like, you can track with your hands down towards your feet. If you can get to your shins and that's a good stretch for you, then just stay here. If you can reach your feet, great. If you can get all the way down and that's still not a stretch, try and flex your feet, and that should increase the stretch a little bit more. So trying to put your nose down by your legs. So this one's a pretty good stretch for me just right here. So I'm going to hang out and breathe into it. So let's go deep breath in and relax. Good. Trying to keep my back as flat as possible, so not too much like a turtle. I know this is a hard one, so just do your best to try and stay in the stretch as well. For another 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Good job. All right. From here, we're going to open our legs up into our middle split position. And from here, we're going to draw our big rainbows up and over. So making sure that our knees are not bent, we want to keep them straight, so no little tunnels. Good job, and we're going to stretch to the other side. Lovely. If you want to put this hand down for support, you can. Good, and we're going to go back to the first side. Lovely, so both sit bones or both bum cheeks on the ground, so not letting that hip come up, keeping it down on the ground. Good, and we'll go back to the second side again. Nice big stretch. Good. All right. And from here, everybody's favorite, I want you to walk your hands out in front of you as far as you can to come into your middle split position. So if you want to rest your elbows on the ground, that's okay. If you want to go for belly on the ground, by all means, go for it. I want you to feel a good stretch in your legs. So find the spot that's the sorest. And try and stay on that one. We're going to hold for 20 seconds. Good. If you like, you can sing a song to yourself, maybe. Makes the time go by a little bit faster. But we're almost done. We've got about 4 seconds. 3, 2, 1. Good job. All right. Give your legs a little shake out. Lovely. I realized now that we forgot to do our butterflies. So from here, let's do our butterflies. Sitting up nice and tall, flapping those butterfly wings. Good. If you'd like to say where you went on an adventure, or where you would go, sorry, on an adventure if you were a butterfly, you can either think of that now to yourself or tell somebody who's around you. Tell them all the places you'd go on your butterfly adventure. Good. And from here, We're going to reach forward with our chest, so bringing it down all the way towards your feet. If you can give those stinky feet a little sniff, pew-wee. Maybe they don't smell too good today. I don't know. All right. Holding, holding, holding there. 3, 2, 1. Good job. All right. I do want to do our middle splits once more. So let's open those legs nice and wide, sitting up tall and walking forwards with your hands. If you can get your belly all the way onto the ground, that's awesome. Just come as far as you can. If that's here, that's totally great. Go until you feel a really good stretch along the inside of your legs here. So coming forward, holding, holding, holding. We're gonna hold for 20 seconds starting now. Good job. Try not to move around in this one. Just hold as best you can. We're almost there, halfway there. Good. 3, 2, 1, and you're done. Good job. All right, bring your legs in. Give them a little shaky shake. Lovely. All right, let's do our splits. So coming up, if you girls remember from last week, we had the books on the side or the pillows, or maybe you used pots, I'm not too sure. Feel free to use those again if you like, if you found that really helpful for you. You also don't have to, it's entirely up to you. So if you want to go grab those now, that's awesome. We'll start with our first stretch. That's the one where we're up on our leg like so. And then we bring the body forward. Good, keeping our knee at the front here as straight as possible. Turned out, a pointed toe. Good job. We're gonna hold for 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Good job. We're gonna come into our second stretch. So that's with our front knee bent and the back one goes straight. Noticing how I'm not too far forward or too far backwards. I'm not into my splits yet. I'm up on this leg, so all my weight's in here. So keeping that back one straight. Good job. And the chest up if you like. Lovely. I'm going to lean my chest forward because I've got a bit of a sore hip. So today this is good for me. Good job. And from here, when you're ready, if you want to spend a little more time here, if you feel you need the stretch, absolutely go ahead. We're going to head into splits. So keeping my hips square, I come down. And notice that both of my hips here are facing forward, not turning to the side like so. They're facing forwards. So I really want you to focus on square hips and square shoulders. So both facing the same direction. If you need to use the books to hold yourself up, that's totally okay. I'd like you to keep square hips and body up. So we're gonna hold for 10 seconds here more. You can do it, girls. Try not to adjust. Stay in one spot. Hold that split position. 2, 1, and you can come out of that one. Good job. All right. When you're ready, we're going to get into the other side. So I'll just switch directions here a little bit. So one knee is bent. All my weight's on this one. My front leg is straight. And I bring my body down. Good job. So holding, holding with a nice straight front leg. Don't let it bend up. Keep it straight. Good. If you forgot about this back toe back here, make sure that guy's pointed too. Good job. And from here, we're going to come into our second stretch. So I just bring my weight forward into my leg. Lovely. I'm going to move back here. So make sure you've got enough room. I'm a little shy on space here. Good job. Really feeling that stretch in the front of the hip. If you'd like to bring the body up, you can put your hands on your leg. Really stretching into that back hip there. So feeling a good stretch. You might even want to put your hands on the ground and arch back a little bit if you'd like. Watch your surroundings, make sure there's nothing you could bump into if you fall. Good, and from here I'm going to head into my splits. So I'm starting with square hips before I go in, and I straighten out my legs, and both my hips are facing as forward as possible. So mine are starting to turn a little bit. So I'm going to come back, re-square my hips, my back knee's facing down towards the ground, and I'm going to hold here. Good. Keeping my body up too. I noticed mine was coming forward a little bit. So just readjust and bring your chest up. Good. Holding for 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Good job. Girls can come out of that one. Give your legs a nice little break. Good job. The next thing we're going to get into is our back flexibility. So when we do our backs, we usually start with our wrists. And same as usual, starting on our hands and knees here, making sure my palms are flat against the ground. We're going to come forwards and backwards. Good. A good stretch in your wrists there. Nice. 7 and 8. Good job. We're going to go to the side like we usually do. So back and forth. Good job. A few more. All right. And then we're going to flip the hands around. So turning them outside instead of inside, we're going to turn out ways. So turning out, doing a nice big stretch here. Good. Keeping your palms on the ground so the heel of your hand stays down. Good. I'm going to kind of just rock backwards a little bit. Nice. All right. Time to do our happy. Actually, let's do some wrist roller coasters. I feel like we haven't done those in a really long time. So shake your wrists out a little bit. And then we're going to do our roller coasters. Good, and roller coaster the other way if you can. Ooh, this looks like a fun ride. Good. All right, give them a little shake out. We're gonna work on our arches now. So from here, we need to do happy kitty and angry kitty first. So up on your hands and knees, we are going to go, let's go happy kitty first. So sinking the belly down to the ground. Arching up. Good job. Holding. And into our angry kitty. So pushing your back up towards the sky. What sound does an angry kitty make? Probably a hissing sound. And a happy kitty would go. Nice, happy kitty. Good. And we're going to go angry kitty again, pushing up. And our happy kitty. Good. And one more angry kitty. And let's finish with a happy kitty. Nice. Good job. From here, we're going to bring our hips down towards the ground and go into our arch position. So as you girls know, first we do with legs together. Arching up as best you can and reaching the head back. I've got a bit of a sore neck too. So that's my maximum today. If you're feeling up to it, feel free to push yourself. Good. And then we're going to do either, I like child's pose. If you girls like to do your rock and rolls, you can do those as well. So that looks like this. So just giving your knees a hug. Rocking back and forth, like so. Good. Just something to stretch your back in the opposite direction. I'm going to do my child's pose and hold for a few seconds. Just give my back a break here. All right. And then we're going to do our arch with our legs apart. Not bending though, keeping them straight. Toes behind me are pointed. nice pointy toes, straight knees, arching up, and then looking back if that's within your abilities. Looking back if you can. Good job holding still. All right, and coming out of that one, going into either your child's pose or your rock and rolls, whichever you prefer.
Resting here.
All right, and now time for our arch with bent legs. So you can do your donut. So bend your legs up and you're trying to reach for your head with your feet. If you can touch, awesome. If you're almost there, just keep on pushing. I know it's hard, but you can do it. You'll get there one day. Keep pushing towards your head. Last week I gave you girls the option of grabbing your leg. So that was this one where you kind of reach up and you grab towards that foot and then, there we go, I got it. And then pull it straight, pulling yourself into the arch. If you want to use a towel or a rope or something else behind, that you can use if you can't quite grab your foot, feel free to do that. But working on getting your donuts, holding your feet, really giving your back that good stretch. When you feel you're done with that one, come on out and back into your child's pose or your rock and rolls.
Give your back a nice break. Good.
And from here, we're gonna go into our bridges. So find a nice open spot. If you need a parent to help you, ask them to just kind of lift your back up and place you back down if you need a little bit of help. That's okay. You can also do bridges over a stack of pillows sometimes. So those would be stacked up and then you kind of arch over top. That's another idea. Get one of your parents to help you maybe, or a sibling. But we're going to do them just on our own today like this, or I am anyways. So my feet nice and strong on the ground. My hands come beside my ears. And then I use my strong muscles to push my belly button up towards the sky and I look towards my fingers. Good, holding for 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Making sure that I look towards my belly button first and then I lower down so that I'm not landing on the top of my head so it hurt my neck potentially. So from here, I'm gonna do a few rock and rolls. Good. All right, ready for our next bridge. So staying nice and strong, feet planted on the ground, hands beside my ears, and then using my muscles, I push up nice and strong. Good job. So looking at our belly button and lowering down. So if there's any parents helping your kids, what you're gonna do is basically just have some support under their back and help them lift up, holding, and then helping them lower back down, making sure that they look at their belly button or chin to chest before they come down so they don't land on their head, of course, but just kind of giving them that extra support when they're in the bridge. We're gonna do one more together, normal bridge, so feet nice and strong, arms come up, pushing, good. Holding those muscles nice and strong, I wanna see flat feet on the ground. So if you're on toes, come back down to flat feet and look at your belly button and come on down. Good job. All right, so that's three bridges. We're gonna do 5 total for the next two. If there are some more advanced girls doing the class, feel free to do your shoulder bridges. So that's pushing your chest forward by straightening your legs. That's gonna really open up the chest. You could do elbow bridges if that's within your abilities. You could also take this time now to do your wall walk. So standing straight and then walking your hands down the wall, whichever progressions, wherever you're at with your flexibility in your back, just feel free to work on those for the next two bridges. I'm gonna do regular bridges. So if that's what you wanna do, please join me, or else take the time to do whatever you'd like. Please be careful though. If you need help from a parent or a sibling, just ask. All right, really important that you don't hurt your back. So pushing up, my feet are strong, my arms are strong, and here we go, pushing up, holding our bridge. Good job. For 3, 2, 1, and looking at the chest, coming down, good. And in between each one, making sure we're doing either a child's pose or a rock and rolls to stretch your back. It's the opposite way. Good, and we're gonna do one more. So standing up strong. Sorry, starting strong. We're not standing, we're lying down. Good. Holding, holding, holding. You can do it, keep strong. For 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and look at your belly button or chin to your chest. Down we go, good. And our rock and rolls now. All right, good job. If you'd like to take some more time, maybe you're having a really good back day and you want to test your flexibility, go for it. Take all the time you want, just pause the video. Be safe, make sure you stretch in the opposite direction, so that's your child's pose or your rock and rolls, whatever you like, just make sure you stretch your back the opposite way after you've done your arches. So I think that's good for stretching now. What I would like to do is some basic ballet with you guys. So I mentioned at the beginning of the video that you might use a chair or maybe a blank space on the wall, something that's free, there's not too much other stuff around, that you can just use for balance. It'll really help when you're first kind of starting out with ballet. I'm gonna do it without, just because I don't really have anything that's suitable for my purposes. So let's get into that quickly now. We'll just do a few basic things. I'm going to set this guy up here. Hopefully you guys can see my feet. All right, wonderful. So from here, you would have something ideally about like belly button height that you could hold on to. So either a countertop, if you're taller, or maybe a stool, a chair, the back of a chair, or just a blank wall space that you can use. So find that now, and we're gonna start our first movement. Which is called plié. So I wish I could have my whole body in here. Maybe not. We'll try this. Right. That's a little bit better. No head, but all you need is legs. For here, let's start with our plié. So that's basically how we squat down to the ground. So we're gonna do demi-plié first. So just holding the hands nice in front, we're gonna open halfway. And then we're gonna stand up. We're gonna do that 8 times. 2 and 3. Notice my heels stay on the ground. 4. And I stay nice and tall through my chest, so I'm not bending forward. I stay up with the chest. And 5, 6. Good. 7 and 8. Lovely. We also wanna try and open the knees to the side instead of the front. So now we're gonna do what we call a grand plié, and that means our bums come all the way down towards the ground. So from here, we open, 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 we hit halfway, and we keep going till we hit the ground. And notice my heels have come up a little bit, that's okay. And then they come back down. That's one. We're gonna do 8 all together. So slow and controlled. This is where the balance might come in handy, so whatever you're balancing on, use that. That's 3. Good, make sure the knees are facing out, so they open to the sides. 4. Good, halfway there. 5. 6. Good. 2 more. 7. Good. And 8. Lovely. So those were demi-plié and grand plié in first position. We're just gonna do in second position. So bringing the legs farther apart now. So notice my heels are not touching. Ready, we're gonna keep our chest up, knees straight, ready for a half bend. And then we come up, two, three, knees out to the side, four, five, six, seven, and eight. Lovely. Ready for our grand plié, so that's where we go all the way down to the ground. Ready, and one, and two, and three, four, good, five, keep the chest up, six, don't forget about your arms, seven, and eight. Lovely. So we're just going to do things, the pliés in first and second position. There's other positions that we can do, which we'll work on over time. The next one we're going to do is called tendu. So that's when your leg comes out in front like so, and then you bring it back. So we're going to do to the front, then we're going to bring the leg to the side, and then we'll go behind as well. So I want you to tap in front of you, and then bring it back. So I'm gonna bring my arms to the side for some balance, but we're gonna go ready, five, six, seven, eight, and we tap, and we bring it back, and two, and three, four, five, six, good, seven, and eight. Lovely. Now we're going to move the leg to the side. One and two, three, four, five, good, six, seven, and eight. Lovely. And now we're going to do the same thing to the back. Ready? And behind tap. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, and eight. Lovely. And we're going to go one more time to the side. Ready? One, two, three, four, five, almost there, six, seven, and eight. Lovely. Good job, guys. Hopefully that was all right for all of you. We're going to do the same thing on the other side. So if you're on a chair, you can either move it around to the other side or you could just turn around. For my purposes, I'm going to stay this way so you guys can see my legs, and I'm just going to use my left leg now. So we're going to do eight to the front, eight to the side, eight behind, and eight to the side, just like we did on the other side. So holding arms nice and strong, and one tap, two, three, four, five. Notice my feet are turned out. Six, same with my leg as it comes out. Seven, and eight, and to the side. One, two, point the toe, three, four, tap, five, good, six, don't forget about your arms up here. Seven, and eight. Good. Now we go behind. One and two, three, four, five. Good. Six. Hold your body strong. Seven and eight. And then one more time to the side. So we go out, two, pointing the toe, three, four, five, six, seven, and eight. Lovely. All right. So those were called tendus. We're going to do something similar, and we're going to point in the front. We're going to tap in the front. We're going to tap in the side and behind, and then front, side, behind. So we're kind of tapping in a little circle. I'll show you how it goes now.
So from here, we're standing tall. I'm going to put my hands on my hips just so you can see that my bum and my hips are not moving around. Try and hold them as steady as possible. So we're going to tap to the front, then we tap to the side, then we tap behind, and then we come forward, and we tap to the side, to behind, and forward. Notice how my leg is staying straight. I should keep it straight here. Front, side, behind, and we sweep it through. Front, side, behind, and through. Front, side, behind, and through. Front, sorry, side, behind, and through. Lovely. Good job. Let's go to the other side now. So holding strong, and we're going to go one to the side, behind, and sweep it through. One, two, three, and sweep it through. Notice that my legs are turned out, behind, and through. See, my foot is nice and turned out. Front, side, back, and through. Knees are straight. Two, three, and four, five, six, seven, and eight. All right, good job. So that is kind of a basic version of what we call rond de jambe, which means round with the leg. So the leg is going around in a circle. Lovely. So that's the kind of basic ballet that we're going to do. We'll just start with that today. If you guys do know more ballet, if you've taken ballet classes together and you just kind of have an urge to do some more ballet, that's awesome. Feel free, go for it. We are going to do some of our apparatus stuff next. So at the beginning of the class, I mentioned you could use a rolling pin or maybe a paper towel. So I'm going to use the paper towel because I do live in an apartment building and there's people down below me. So instead of dropping a rolling pin and maybe making a really loud noise for them, I'm going to use something a little softer. So if this drops on the ground, one, it's not going to break. Two, it's not going to make too loud of a noise. So ask your parents for something, either a paper towel roll or some girls have used a rolling pin before. So just find something. It could be something other than these two. It doesn't have to be either one of these, but just something that you can roll with. So what we're going to start with is the roll on the front of the body. I'm going to put my camera up a little bit here so you guys can see. Lovely. So from here, we're going to start with standing nice and tall. And just my, I rest the toilet paper or the paper towel on my shoulders just in front here. And then I have just my little fingers on. So I'm not holding it up like this. There's that space in between. So I hold with just my fingers. So just up top. And then when I straighten out my arms in front of me, the paper towel should roll. So from here, we straighten out the arms and the paper towel will roll down. Good. So I will leave it up to you girls, but I would like you to do 10 perfect tries. So that means from here, you have to catch it at the end. And that counts as a perfect one. So you be the judge of what you call perfect. And I want you to do 10 of those. All right. Good. And from here, I also forgot to mention, if you do have your sock ball that you made with Angela, you can use that too. I totally forgot about that. So if you have your ball, that's awesome. Use that. What we're going to do next is we're going to practice the same thing in our passe balance. So first, I want you to get ready for your roll. So bring the toilet paper or paper towel or rolling pin or ball that you have up to your chest. And then we zipper up with our leg, holding, 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 whoop, and we go roll. And once we're finished, then we zipper back down. Good. We're going to go on the other leg. So bring your paper towel up, get ready to go. Zipper up with your leg, holding nice and strong. Roll that ball down and zipper down. Good. So I want you to do, if you can, 10 perfect tries like that as well.
The next roll we're going to work on is our single arm roll. This might be a little bit hard with the paper towel roll because it's kind of tippy. So, and especially with the rolling pin, I wouldn't recommend. If you have the sock ball, go ahead and try this one. But from here, if you're comfortable doing it on one side, yeah, that's quite tippy. So if you're comfortable with your ball rolling on one side like so, please do that. If you want to start by holding it and then letting it roll down, you can try that as well. So as you can see, not the greatest thing to do with the paper towel roll or the rolling pin would be quite tippy. So yeah, if you have the ball, use that. If not, that's okay. We're going to move on to another roll. So I want you to start from here. And I want you to place the paper towel roll on your neck. And notice that my body's bent over. I'm not standing up straight because this is like falling off a cliff. I want to create a nice little hill for my paper towel to roll down my back. So we're going to work on this one. Rolling. Good. And if you find it's rolling too fast, if you're up like this, ready? Watch. It goes pew, way too fast down. There's no way I can catch that one. So I want to make sure that I'm bent over enough, and then I can roll it gently down my back. So we're going to be doing 10 perfect ones of that. So you've got to catch it with both hands behind you. So once you've done your 10, you're ready to move on to the next one. And that one is down on the ground. So let's bring this guy, this guy down again. And we're gonna work on rolls on our legs. So from here, just sitting nice and tall, I want you to roll that paper towel down to your feet. Good job, holding. Making sure that it doesn't fly off the end. So if you need to flex your feet, that's okay. Good. So we're doing 10 of those ones. Perfect tries. And then now for the hard part, we're going to roll up the other way. So starting with the paper towel at your ankles, I want you to lean back and lift your legs so that it rolls up towards your belly. Good. So watch how I lean back with my body, lift my legs, and it rolls all the way to me. Really important on this one that you lift the legs at the same time. If I lift one leg before, it's going to fall off to the side. So both legs at the same time come up and roll. Good. So 10 of those ones, lifting legs at the same time. Now from here, we're going to roll down and back. See if you can lift the legs just in time when the paper towel roll gets to the end. So as soon as it comes down here, I need to lift my legs to bring it back up. So this is the next progression, rolling back up. All the way down and up. Good. So this one's a bit tricky, so it might take you a little bit longer to get your 10, but that's okay. Take your time. Good. Really important key is to lift the legs at the same time. So not tipping to one side or the other. You got to lift them both together. So from here, we're down and up. Good job. All right. So take your time. Finish those ones. I want to see 10 perfect if you can. If 10's really too much for you and it's never going to happen, or it's just you're finding it really, really challenging, aim for 5 then. Whatever works for you at this point. All right, next one we're going to try. We're going to come all the way down, lie on our belly, and we're going to try and roll it down our back. So from here, we'll just start at our neck, and then when I lift, so here it's not rolling. When I lift my shoulders up, it rolls all the way down to my feet. See if you can get it all the way down there. So grab your paper towel, balance it in the middle on your neck, and then when you lift your body up, it should roll all the way down. Good job. Oh, that one only made it to my knees, but that's okay. Just as far as you can go. So from here again, balancing on your neck, and then when you lift up into arch a little bit, whoop, it rolls all the way down. Good job. And then you can grab your paper towel again. If it's making it all the way to your feet, that's awesome. If it only makes it to your knees or even your low back, that's good too. Try and work up to a good progression of that one. The other option If you girls are ready for it, if you feel like you want a real big challenge, from here, you can start with it at your legs, or sorry, at your ankles. So when it's down, oh, that one went right off my feet. might be easier to have a family member, a sibling, brother, sister, kind of set it on your feet for you behind you first, because it's a bit hard to get it down there. Not sure if I can even do it. There we go.
Oh, no, not happening.
So from here, good. So we want it at our ankles like so, so that when we lift up our legs, it's gonna roll up towards our low back. So from here, I'm keeping my back down. I lift my legs and it rolls up. So then you're gonna need someone to put it down again for you, or it might roll. Nope, mine's not gonna roll. So get someone to put it down at your ankles. Yeah. Good. So down at your ankles, like so, you're gonna lift up and it's gonna roll all the way up to your back. So that's a pretty challenging one. Again, like I said, if you need a family member to help you put it down at your ankles, get them to help you, and they could even try as well. Have your brother or sister maybe play along, or your parent try and learn the roll. It's fun to get the whole family involved in gymnastics. So those are some of the variations of the rolls that we're gonna work on today. If you girls can come up with some other cool rolls, maybe you roll it kind of down the back of your arm one way, or any other type of interesting things you can come up with. We always love to see this kind of stuff as well. So take a photo, take a video, send it in. Angela, Kiki, myself, and Danielle, we always love to see what you guys are up to, getting creative and stuff like that. So have a little bit of fun with it. Cool. So that's pretty much all I had planned for today. One last thing that I know lots of girls like to do is kind of like a free dance time. So if you have some time now and you want to stick around and just have some music on and dance around, if you have apparatus at home, feel free to use that, have a little play. I'm going to put on some music right now for you guys to hear. Hopefully you can hear it. And just listen to the music, and I want you to do movements that you think suit the type of music that it is. So if it's slow and soft, I want you to dance slow and soft. If it's wild and crazy, you can absolutely go wild and crazy, shake it, have some fun, dance around, jump around, things like that. So depending on what the music is, that's how I want you to move your body and what you think the music would look like in a body. So let's start with a fun one. Hopefully you guys can hear this. Cool. So it's kind of like Spanish guitar music. So you tell me what this looks like.
Ese amor llega sin esta manera. No tiene la culpa. Caballo levanta mano porque muy despreciado por eso. No te perdono llorar. Ese amor llega así, esta manera. No tiene la culpa. Amor de compraventa, amor del pasado. Ven, 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 ven.
Music I had in mind. All right, what's the next one? Ready? Oh, wow. Very different, right? So, soft and smooth. Nice. Beautiful. turns. Good, nice smooth arms. Ready, we can do a turn that we know. Good. Totally different, right? Now, let's hear one last one. Ooh, this is a fun one. Ready? Wow! It's wild and crazy. Go for it. Good job. You can play a guitar if you want. Yeah. It's just an apparatus kick, so I have my thing. I could do rolls. I can even toss it up and catch it. You girls go crazy with this one. Awesome. All right. So that's just a little preview. If you guys want to put on some more music, ask your parents to put on a fun song, have a little dance around, play with your apparatus, enjoy the music. All right. So that is all for this week. I hope you guys enjoyed it. And like I said before, if you do get up to some fun, interesting, creative things, feel free to send us the photos or videos of that. We always, always, always love to see what you guys are up to. Again, I hope you enjoyed, and we will see you again soon. All right. Take care, everybody. See you later.